And we're back on the Blitz as we take a look at second chance highlights coming up, and certainly an exciting night for the West Orange Stark Mustangs, an impressive win over Silsbee.
That's right, 21-3A, the district championship on the line. It is our game of the week. And here's a look at those Tigers. They were rolling into Mustang country tonight to the corral, and they would have a rude awakening because the chain gang, they came to play. Yeah, there he is. Deontay Thompson, a sophomore with a verbal commit to Alabama. Roll Tide, roll. He had the big hit there, and then guess what? He comes up with the interception. Nick Saban knows how to find some pretty good players. He's going the other way.
He may go to the University of Texas by the time 2 years. He may be recruiting him for Texas.
I wouldn't hold your breath, Longhorn fans, just saying. Anyway, Dylan Sterling Cole to Dwayne Bullard, 21-0. They just like to start stories out there in Austin. Just saying.
They got a new athletic director. He's a hatchet man, I heard.
Now, Reed in trouble.
Oh, I don't want to see that. No.
That's right. Reed in trouble goes down. One play later, he was out. Then the Mustangs pulling out trickeration. That's Chase Rutledge, who's a receiver, was the starting quarterback at the beginning of the year, and he has a touchdown pass. West Orange Star Cup 27-0. And guess what? That was your final. They go on cruise control after that. They are your district champions. They'll play Thursday night against Huffman.
For a postgame report, let's send it out to Lance Edwards, who's at Hook Stadium at West Orange.
West Orange Star completes the shutout tonight, 27-0. Undefeated in District 21-3A against the Silsbee Tigers tonight. I'm joined with Elijah Teal, defensive senior here, who has never lost to the Silsbee Tigers, never lost a district game. Talk about how that pride stands out for you.
It's all about just working hard and just playing with Coach T. Coach T gonna tell us what to do. We execute it, then good things happen.
Talk about some of the plays your teammates made in that first half. You know, got after it early, a couple big hits, you know, things going on in the game. Talk about those big plays early.
We had a couple of fumble recovery, tackles for losses. We was just coming together as a unit. Everybody was pursuing to the ball. They couldn't answer for it.
Everybody talks about the chain gang defense. It's back, right?
Yes, sir. It's back. It's in action.
Is that something y'all talk about in daily work, at practice every day?
Well, we don't talk about it. It's just like something that happens. Like, as long as we're working hard, it's chain gang right there. We don't do no talking.
All right. Last thing I want to ask you, you got the playoffs coming up, Huffman, this Thursday night. Coach just told y'all, you go celebrate, then you're back to work. Talk about your expectations.
My expectations are no different from what happened tonight. Executing the defensive side of the ball, playing hard, moving around, having the offense execute good things happen, and play together as a team, a family. Let's show some more of the chain gang defense.
All right, Elijah, congratulations on the victory tonight. Go enjoy it and get ready for next week, all right? All right, there you have it. 27-0, West Orange Stark wins tonight. That was Elijah Teal. The chain gang defense is back. You heard it. I don't know if it went anywhere. Lance Edwards reporting for the Blitz.
Thanks again, Lance. Great job tonight. Again, pulling double duty by shooting the P&G Livingston game, also hustling over there to West Orange to get the postgame reaction from the Mustangs. And once again, obviously, with that defense, they're going to be tough to beat, a tough out.
That's right. They looked nasty tonight, a lot of hard hits. Elsewhere in 21-3A, still plenty of things being decided, including Hardin Jefferson trying to get to the postseason for the first time since 2008. Their rival Hampshire Finette with a slight chance at ending their drought that dates back to 2003.
Out to Hawk Stadium we go. Hardin Jefferson hitting the field, coming off win, close loss, I should say, 34-33 to Silsbee last week. Hampshire Finette coming up a bye week, well-rested, and certainly well-rested is their quarterback, Kendrick King. He's a playmaker. Just give him the football as he picks up 25 yards on this game, starting the opening drive of the football game scoreless. Then it's Tanner Boot Dubois going the other way. Dubois down close to the one-yard line. Gieske with a touchdown-saving tackle, but King would punch it in from there for a 7-0 Hampshire Finette lead. But as we go to the scoreboard, the Hawks come back in a big way and win it 48-20. Congratulations to first-year head coach Dwayne Dubois and the Hawks. They're headed to the postseason.
Now let's go out for the Bayou Bowl. This one, Bridge City and Orangefield, got a little nasty right before halftime. That's what's going to happen between rivals sometime. We go to the first quarter action. That's when Chase Sugar, he was a heck of a pitcher, especially in Little League. Remember when he led Bridge City to the regional championship in the Southwest region? Now he's slinging the rock around there on the gridiron. Finds Blaine Slaughter here for the first down. Then Sugar to Slaughter one more time as they are driving this one. Orangefield needing a win to get into the playoffs. Now Jet Simmons, he's going to take the handoff, finds the blockers. He is in 7-0. But Orangefield, they would rally in this one as we go to the final. Bobcats, they take it 35-35. 14. Orangefield is heading to the playoffs. As we go ahead and check on the playoff teams, West Orange and Silsby in D1, while D2 has HJ and Orangefield.
First time in 10 years for the Bobcats. How about the battle for the District 24 championship? Nederland's already clinched the tie. 6-0, taking on 5-1 Central at the Thomas Center tonight. Big crowd on hand as Nederland takes the early lead on this Kendrick Hopkins touchdown. 7-0, Bulldogs on top. Now for the Central Jaguars, their playmaker is Michael Jacquet. We saw him all over the highlights last week against LCM in that big road win. He is tough to bring down in the open field, but for the most part, Nederland was able to keep him in check as he runs it past the 50-yard line. Finally brought down. Now it was a third down and one for Central as the crowd goes crazy. Watch the Nederland defense here. Sack, Cayman Darby for a loss. They would be forced to punt. 7-0 Nederland at the half as we check the final. The Bulldogs go on to the win. It's now 24-game district winning streak, 21-7. And, of course, Central next week. Now it's to take on Summer Creek in the playoffs.
Out to Viders. We have the Pirates taking on LCM. Batlin Bears trying to avoid Crosby in the first round. They would do that with the win. Nice pass from Caleb Harley to Dalton Doyle. Big first down. Then Brandon Tolliver picking up some nice yardage. LCM would go toe-to-toe with the Pirates. Vider not backing down, but in the end, LCM takes it. Your final tonight from Pirate Stadium was 17-13.
So that means the PNG Indians will be the 2 seed in Division 2 from District 24A with that LCM victory. But the Indians still motivated on senior night at the reservation, especially on defense. Watch Chris Mangini come in to finish off the sack there in the first quarter. Then Livingston trying to pass, their quarterback rolling out, throwing deep, but it's Corbin Coy with the interception, headed back the other way. Drive would culminate with a Brent Halpin touchdown. He had 2 touchdowns in the first half. As we check the final in this one, PNG ready for the playoffs next week, 49-6 over Livingston.
They'll take on the Crosby Cougars in the first round. Remember, Crosby knocked off and gave Nederland their only loss of the year. How about Ozan and Lumberton playing for pride out on the soggy turf of Raiders Stadium? That's Joshua Boyd with a nice pickup there after faking off the handoff. Then DeMarco Williams, he is going to take this one to the house. 28-14 Panthers, and they go on to win it. Lumberton finishing winless for the year. They showed some promise at times as they fall 35-21. Here's a look at your playoff teams from 24A. Nederland gets the top slot in D1. LCM gets that top slot in D2. Congratulations to all of our playoff teams.
We've come to another break on this regular edition final of the Blitz. More second chance highlights coming up, including Koontz trying to do something they haven't done in 40 years.
That's right, but now it's time for the hit of the week.
The hit of the week.
Our hit of the week at the game of the week. Future Crimson Tide member out of Alabama. We're talking about Deontay Thompson, Ramajama Yellowhammer. That is our hit of the week.